गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आर यू डूइंग योर स्टडीज एट होम? यस, एंड ड्रिंकिंग लॉट ऑफ वाटर ऑल्सो? यस, स्टूडेंट्स डू ड्रिंक वाटर इन अ डे. यस, बिकॉज नाउ समर सीजन इज गोइंग ऑन. यस, एंड इन दिस सीजन अ बॉडी रिक्वायर्स अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर. सो वी शुड ड्रिंक अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर आफ्टर एवरी वन आवर. ओके, so drink lot of water. By this, let me start with my social science class. And in social science, we are discussing chapter number 5. Yes, the southern plateaus. In our earlier class, we have discussed about what is plateaus, location of southern plateaus, Malwa plateau, Chota Nagpur plateau, Deccan Plateau, and we have also discussed about the life in southern plateaus, like we have discussed about the life in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu state, which comes in southern plateau. Yes, so today we will just do a quick recapitulation of the life in the southern plateaus, state Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, and then we will move to our today's topic, life in the southern plateau, the states which come in the southern plateau, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. Yes, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Yes, so we will discuss about Andhra Pradesh and Telangana in today's topic. But we will first do a quick recapitulation. And what? So sit straight, all of you are ready? Yes, so let's start. We will talk first about Karnataka. To the south of Maharashtra is Karnataka. Krishna, Tungbhadra and Kaveri rivers flow through this state. So this state Karnataka is towards the south of Maharashtra. Maharashtra is here, and towards the south of Maharashtra we have Karnataka state. Here in Karnataka state, river Krishna, Tungbhadra and Kaveri river flows in this state, from this state. Most of the people are farmer in Karnataka. The main crops grown here are jowar, ragi, cotton, coffee, sugar cane and spices. Yes, so these are the main crops grown here in the state Karnataka. Bangalore, now called Bengaluru, is the capital of Karnataka. It is known as the Garden City. So Bengaluru is called as a Garden City because of its many parks. Okay, it is a big industrial center. It has many factories producing aeroplane, watches, telephone, machinery. So here in Karnataka, it is a big industrial center. It has many factories where aeroplanes, watches and telephone machines are being made. Recently, computer industry has made its world famous. So recently, computer industry has been established, which has made it a world famous. It is now called a Silicon Valley of the East. So now Bengaluru is called as the Silicon Valley of the East. Okay. The main cities of Karnataka state are Mysore, Hubballi, Belagavi and Dharavar. These are the main cities in the state Karnataka. Men wear dhoti kurta and women wear sari and blouse. So you can see here, men are wearing dhoti kurta and the woman is wearing sari and blouse in Karnataka state. Yes, the main language spoken in Karnataka, the people of Karnataka speak Kannad. People are fond of music and dance here. Yakas Hangana is the traditional folk theater of Karnataka. So here, this is Hakkas Hangana. This is a folk theater. This is a play which is a traditional folk play which is being played in the theaters of Karnataka. Carnatic music is popular throughout the country. So here the people, you know, have a Carnatic music which is very popular throughout the country, India. Mysuru is famous for its Dashera celebration. So in Karnataka we have another city, Mysuru, which is very famous for its Dashera celebration at the Mysuru place and Vrindavan garden. So this Dashera celebration is being celebrated in Mysuru palace, this Mysuru place, and this is Vrindavan garden. where the Shala celebration is being performed or held. Now we will talk about the another state which comes in the southern plateaus. We will talk about the life in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu lies to the south of the Karnataka. So here we have Karnataka state, and towards the south of Karnataka we have Tamil Nadu state here. So Tamil Nadu lies to the south of Karnataka. This state also comes in the southern plateaus. Farming is the main occupation of the people. Rice, sugarcane, cotton and groundnuts are the main crops grown here in Tamil Nadu state. In the hills of Nilgiri, coffee and tea are grown. Tamil Nadu is one of the most industrialized states of India. So here Tamil Nadu is also one of the most industrialized states of India. Means there are so many industries in this state. The Integral Coach Factory at Perambur makes railway coaches. So here the Integral Coach Factory in Perambur city makes railway coaches. Kanchipuram is famous for its silk sari. So in Kanchipuram is famous for its silk sari. Silk sari are very famous of Kanchipuram. Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu, and Tamil is the main language spoken here in Tamil Nadu. If we talk about the food, South Indian food comprise dosa, idli, upma and sambar. People here eat. People, the main food of Tamil Nadu, the main the main food which the people here eat are dosa, idli, upma and sambar. It is popular all over the country. So this South Indian food is very famous all over the country. We also make idli, sambar, dosa, yes, upma, yes, and we also like the South Indian dishes, yes. The men wear lungi and shirt, and the girl wear long skirt called pavades. So here the men wear lungi and shirt, and the girls wear long skirt called pavades. Bharatanatyam is the classical dance of Tamil Nadu. So here in Tamil Nadu, the classical dance which is performed by the people of Tamil Nadu is Bharatanatyam. So Bharatanatyam is a classical dance of Tamil Nadu. Pongal is the most important festival celebrated here by the people of Tamil Nadu. So you can see here the people are celebrating Pongal festival, which is the most important festival of the people living in the state Tamil Nadu. Yes, Tamil Nadu is famous for its temples. So here in Tamil Nadu state we have lots of temples also. Some of the famous temples are Meenakshi Sundarayeshwaram temple, which is in Madurai, Nataraja temple, which is in Chidambaram, and Rameshwaram temple. So these are some of the famous temples which are there in Tamil Nadu state. Yes. Now we will talk about Andhra Pradesh, then another state which comes in the southern plateaus. We will talk about the life in Andhra Pradesh state. Yes, students. So Andhra Pradesh is the largest of the southern states. So Andhra Pradesh state is the largest state in the which comes in the southern plateaus, and it is the largest state of the southern state. Andhra Pradesh is the largest state of the southern states. If we talk about all the southern states, Andhra Pradesh is the largest state. It lies to the north of Tamil Nadu. So where is Tamil Nadu? Tamil Nadu is here, and towards the north of Tamil Nadu there is a Andhra Pradesh state. Yes, farming is the main occupation of the people here in Tamil Nadu. The main crops grown here are rice, jowar, tobacco, chilies and sugarcane. Andhra Pradesh is the largest producer of tobacco in the world. So this state Andhra Pradesh is the largest producer of tobacco in the world. So they export tobacco, we export tobacco to in the different countries of the world from Andhra Pradesh state. Bidri work on brass and copper is very beautiful. So here in Andhra Pradesh people do bidri work on brass and copper. You can see here brass and copper is there, and bidri work, this flowers they are making, this is a bidri work. The important cities of Andhra Pradesh are Visakhapatnam, Vijayawada, Guntur, Nellore and Anantapur. So these are the important cities of the state Andhra Pradesh. This is a map of Andhra Pradesh. Here we have Visakhapatnam, here we have Anantapuram, here we have Nellore, here we have Guntur and here we have Vijayawada. So these are the important cities which are there in Andhra Pradesh. मेनी पीपल विजिट तिरुपति टू प्रे एट श्री वेंकटेश्वरम टेम्पल. सो हियर वी हैव अ तिरुपति यू नो गॉड एंड मेनी पीपल विजिट हियर टू यू नो प्रे तिरुपति एट श्री वेंकटेश्वरम टेम्पल. दिस इज अ वेंकटेश्वर टेम्पल. कुचिपुड़ी इज द फेमस डांस फॉर्म ऑफ दिस स्टेट आंध्र प्रदेश. दिस इज अ डांस परफॉर्मेंस कुचिपुड़ी डांस. कुचिपुड़ी इज द फेमस डांस ऑफ द स्टेट आंध्र प्रदेश. Ugadi is the new year festival in Andhra Pradesh. So this is a Ugadi festival. The people are celebrating Ugadi festival, which is a new year festival celebrated in Andhra Pradesh. Pongal is also celebrated here. So here also Pongal is celebrated by the people of Andhra Pradesh. Now we will talk about Andhra Pradesh. In Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad. Charminar is the landmark of the city of Hyderabad. This city is now served as the capital of both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. So here in Andhra Pradesh, the city Hyderabad is there. Hyderabad is the capital of Andhra Pradesh as well as Telangana now. And this city has a Charminar. This is a Charminar, which is a landmark of the city Hyderabad. Lumbini Park, Chaumarhala Palace and Salur Jung Museum are the famous tourist palaces in Hyderabad. So you can see here, this one is Lumbini Park, this is a Chaumala Palace, and this is a what? Salur Jung Museum. Okay. Now we will talk about the another state which comes in the southern plateau, that is the Telangana state. On 2nd June 2014, Telangana was created as a new 29th state of India. So earlier we were having, before 2014, we were having only 28 states. But after 2nd June 2014, Telangana was created as a new 29th state of India. So earlier it was a part of Andhra Pradesh only, and we were having 28 states in India. But after 2014 June, the Andhra Pradesh was divided into two parts. One was Telangana, and Telangana was made as a state, and one part was Andhra Pradesh. So it was carved out of the state Andhra Pradesh. As I have told you, it was carved out from the state Andhra Pradesh. Here you can see here, this is Andhra Pradesh, and this part, this where I have you know shown with the black line, this whole is a Telangana state, and this one is a Andhra Pradesh state. It is bordered by Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh to the north. So Telangana is having border, is bordered through from Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Maharashtra from the north side, Karnataka to the west. Where is Karnataka? Karnataka to the west, and Andhra Pradesh to the south. Where is Andhra Pradesh? Andhra Pradesh to the south. Here we have Andhra Pradesh. So towards the south, there is Andhra Pradesh. Towards the north of Telangana, there is Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh. And towards the west, we have Karnataka state, which is bounding, which is having bordered to Telangana state. Yes. Major cities, if we talk about Telangana state, are Hyderabad, Warangal, Nizamabad, Kazimnagar and Kharanmam. So these are the important states of these are the important cities of Telangana. Yes, and Hyderabad is the capital of Telangana. Thousand pillar temples at Warangal. So here we have a thousand pillar temple also in Warangal city, which is in the state Telangana. This temple has thousand pillars. So this temple is called as Thousand Pillar Temple, which is at Warangal in Telangana state. Now students, what we have today studied? We have studied about the southern states which come in the southern plateaus. We have studied about the state Karnataka. We have studied about the state Tamil Nadu. We have studied about the state Andhra Pradesh. And we have studied about the state Telangana. Yes, so these all are the states, the life in these states. We have discussed that what the music the people here, you know, perform, what are the dance form they perform, what type of food they eat, and what type of occupation these people are doing. What type of occupation, what type of crops they are growing, what type of dress they are wearing. Yes, these all things we have discussed in today's class. about the southern plateaus, and we have discussed some of the states which are there in the southern plateau. In the next class, we will discuss about the other states which comes in the southern plateau. Yes, now there is a homework for you all. And what is the homework, students? Yes, what is the homework? And the homework is read page number 35, chapter number 5, the southern plateaus. Okay, so what you have to do, students, till what we have discussed today, you have to read the book, chapter number 5. Whatever queries you have, you can just underline it and you can ask in the doubt clearing session. Yes? Yes, students? So now with this, thank you and have a nice day. Enjoy your day and play.